Good evening. You're watching Election Express here on India Today. I'm Akshata Nandagopal, and this evening we're putting the focus on the big showdown over a doctored video of Home Minister Amit Shah being shared widely on caste quota. Now, the authorities, the Delhi police, has cracked the whip, issuing a notice even to Telangana Chief Minister Revanth Reddy after the Telangana Congress shared that doctored video. We'll be getting you the latest on that political showdown and the first reaction from Revanth Reddy. Let's begin with the headlines. Prime Minister Modi slams Congress over fake Amit Shah video claiming he will end quota for all. BJP moves election commission. Sources say Telangana Chief Minister Revanth Reddy likely to be summoned. Sexual abuse stained to JDS. HD Devegowda's son and grandson Prajwal Revanna accused of sexual abuse. Sources say JDS will expel Prajwal. Final call to be taken tomorrow. Rahul Gandhi triggers reservation storm again, reiterates BJP will end reservation, says Prime Minister Modi is trying to finish the constitution. Prime Minister Modi hits back, says Congress is misleading people. Big nomination day in Uttar Pradesh. Smriti Rani files nomination from Amethi. Raksha Mantri Rajnath Singh from Lucknow amid big saffron show of strength in Uttar Pradesh. Partial relief for the Mamata government. Supreme Court stays CBI investigation into teachers' recruitment scam. This after Calcutta High Court cancelled over 24,000 teacher recruitments. And pro-Palestine protests continue at US universities. Protesters camp inside Varsity India Today. Reports from Ground Zero at Berkeley.
Their biggest demand as of right now is to ensure that the UC system divests their money from anything that contributes to the war efforts in Gaza. And they intend on staying here until their demands are met.
All right, let's get you, in fact, breaking news that's coming in right now on this broadcast. Telangana Chief Minister has spoken out on the Amit Shah doctored video and the summons reportedly that have been issued to him. Sources telling us that Revanth Reddy is going to be summoned. Revanth Reddy reacting to this has claimed that there is an attempt to arrest him and has dared the BJP to go ahead and take action, saying after the ED and the CBI, the Delhi police is now being misused by the BJP. Revanth Reddy is saying that this is a direct dare to the BJP. I will defeat Modi and Shah in Telangana. Let's play out for you the first reaction from the Telangana Chief Minister.
CBI को इस्तेमाल कर रहे थे चुनाव जीतने के लिए. अभी मेरे समाचार मिला है तेलंगाना कांग्रेस पार्टी ऑफिस में दिल्ली पुलिस पहुंचा हुआ है. सोशल मीडिया में कोई पोस्टिंग लगाया, इसीलिए तेलंगाना के कांग्रेस अध्यक्ष को, तेलंगाना मुख्यमंत्री को हम अरेस्ट करते बोल के नोटिस लेकर तेलंगाना गांधी भवन में पहुंच गए. इसका मतलब नरेंद्र मोदी जी ईडी इनकम टैक्स सीबीआई हो गए, अभी दिल्ली पुलिस को इस्तेमाल कर रहे चुनाव जीतने के लिए. यहाँ पर कोई धरने वाले नहीं है भाई, यहाँ पर पलट के जवाब देने वाले है. देखेंगे आने वाले चुनाव में नरेंद्र मोदी जी और अमित शाह को हरा के दिखाएंगे कर्नाटक और तेलंगाना में.
Okay, so that is the first reaction coming in from Telangana Chief Minister Revanth Reddy, who has spoken out on the Amit Shah doctored video. This video was shared, remember, by the Telangana Congress. The Delhi police has reached Hyderabad, issued a notice to the Telangana Chief Minister, and Revanth Reddy, who's currently campaigning in Karnataka, has spoken out and has said that this is an attempt to go ahead and arrest him, that the BJP, after the ED and CBI, is using the Delhi police now to target him. But his message to the BJP is clear. He's saying, bring it on. I'm not scared. I will go ahead and take on this issue head on. Now we're seeing, in fact, a reaction coming in from the Telangana Chief Minister amid this entire controversy playing out over a video, a doctored video of Amit Shah being shared by the Telangana Congress. And let's get you more breaking news coming in on this story. There's also been an arrest in this case. Remember that this video was being shared widely, and there's a crackdown by the Delhi police against anyone who shared it. And Assam Congress worker has been arrested for sharing this doctored fake video. The Assam police have arrested an individual named Ritum Singh in connection with this video, doctored video involving Amit Shah, which is being shared. Assam Chief Minister Himanta Biswa Sarma has confirmed that there has been an arrest made and that this Assam Congress worker has been taken into custody for sharing a fake video. Now, what exactly is this controversy all about? One arrest taking place, a notice being issued to a sitting chief minister. Let's run you through exactly what's playing out on social media that's now triggered this crackdown by the Delhi police.
भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार बनेगी तो एक गैर संवैधानिक मुस्लिम रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे। ये अधिकार तेलंगाना के एससी एसटी और ओबीसी का है, वो अधिकार उनको मिलेगा और मुस्लिम रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे।
द रियल वीडियो।
भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार बनेगी तो एक गैर संवैधानिक एससी एसटी और ओबीसी का है, वो रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे। रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे।
एंड दिस इज हाउ इट वॉज डॉक्टर्ड एंड स्निप्ड टू मेक अ फेक वीडियो। द एडिशन ऑफ टेक टूल्स टू अ विशिएटेड पॉलिटिकल एटमॉस्फेयर इज कीपिंग फैक्ट चेकर्स ऑन देयर टोज। And many videos are now doing the rounds to mislead voters. The latest is Home Minister Amit Shah's doctored video, fact-checked by India Today.
भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार बनेगी तो एक गैर संवैधानिक एससी एसटी और ओबीसी का है, वो रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे। रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे। भारतीय जनता पार्टी की सरकार बनेगी तो एक गैर संवैधानिक मुस्लिम रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे। ये अधिकार तेलंगाना के एससी एसटी और ओबीसी का है, वो अधिकार उनको मिलेगा और मुस्लिम रिजर्वेशन को हम समाप्त कर देंगे।
दिस वीडियो वॉज इवन शेयर्ड बाय द तेलंगाना कांग्रेस which has led to the Delhi police landing up now in Hyderabad. Telangana CM Revanth Reddy has also been summoned now by the Delhi police.
Right now we are exactly in front of Chief Minister Revanth Reddy's residence here, where what we are hearing is that Delhi police have come here and gave a notice or served a notice to the Chief Minister's office stating that by May 1 Chief Minister Revanth Reddy has to appear with all the gadgets.
The BJP has lashed out at the Congress for sharing a doctored video to spread fake news, and leading the charge was Prime Minister Modi.
जो लोग चुनाव हार चुके हैं, मैदान खो चुके हैं, ये लोग इन दिनों टेक्नोलॉजी का उपयोग करके फेक वीडियो बना रहे हैं। आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस का दुरुपयोग करते हुए उनको सबक सिखाया जाएगा। ये देश का कानून किसी के साथ भी प्रकार के खेल खेलने की इजाजत नहीं देता है।
द तेलंगाना कांग्रेस शेयरिंग दिस वीडियो हैज स्पार्क्ड अ वॉर ऑफ वर्ड्स इन द स्टेट टू।
गलत वीडियोस आवाम के अंदर पहुंचाना और लोगों के ऊपर गलत इल्जाम लगाना, खास कर बीजेपी के ऊपर जो लोगों के हित में काम कर रहे हैं, इनका ये जिंदगी का आम आदत हो गया है।
बीजेपी 400 सीट इसलिए पूछ रहे हैं, अगर सरकार में 400 सीट के हाथ आए तो 3/4 मेजोरिटी के साथ ये रिजर्वेशन हटाएगा। इसमें क्या फर्जी वीडियो बनाने की जरूरत नहीं। आज काउंटर कर रहे आप रिजर्वेशन, हम नहीं हटाएंगे, नहीं बढ़ाते बोल के नहीं बोल रहे, क्यों नहीं बढ़ाते?
द कंट्रोवर्सी has reignited the debate over the spread of misinformation during elections, with a growing demand for stricter regulation and accountability. Bureau Report, India Today.
And let me bring in our reporters on this broadcast. Abdul Bashir joining us live from Hyderabad. We have Arvind Oja getting us the latest on the Delhi police investigation. Abdul, to you first. First reaction coming in from the Telangana Chief Minister. Revant Reddy confirming that yes, a notice has been issued, but he's completely dismissed it, saying all of this is a political conspiracy. He's been issued this notice because he's also the Telangana Congress Chief, and the Telangana Congress shared this video.
Well, absolutely. See, Akshita, this is not the first time that Telangana Congress Chief Revant Reddy has shared this video in particular, but he also has been vocal about the BJP and RSS, where he had clearly stated in the press conferences while speaking to us also, he's mentioned that if BJP is voted to power, then SC, ST and OBC reservation will be abolished, is what he clearly stated. And he had been vocal about it. And recently, the doctored video is allegedly shared by a TPCC chief, Revant Reddy, after which a notice had been issued by the Delhi police.
So, Abdul, was this video shared by Revant Reddy, or was the video shared on the Telangana Congress handle?
Well, what we are getting to know is that Telangana Congress handle had shared this video. Now, because the Revant Reddy is also Telangana PCC chief, he had been served this notice. But allegations that Telangana Congress chief is directly into this, and his handle also has been used, has been put up. But the police is right now investigating. Four members apart from Revant Reddy who had received this notice are Manish Satish, who is the social media in charge for the Telangana Congress committee, Naveen Shivshankar and Asma Taslina. So these four members, including Revant Reddy, the fifth member in this Delhi police, have issued notice and asked Revant Reddy to appear on May 1st. With the gadget, with the phone from which this tweet has been posted, or this claim, this video, doctored video had been posted. So now Revant Reddy, while reacting to this particular notice that had been issued in while speaking from Karnataka, he had said that the BJP is not only using the agencies but also the Delhi police, and he's ready for any kind of investigation. He's ready for a fight pertaining to this particular issue, is what he said.
Let's just play out for our viewers once again what Revant Reddy's statement is on the notice that's been issued to him. At no point really does he speak about the post itself that was shared, but he calls all of this a political conspiracy. Let's just listen into what Revant Reddy has said.
CBI ko istemal kar rahe the chunav jeetne ke liye. Abhi mere samachar mila hai Telangana Congress Party office mein. दिल्ली पुलिस पहुंचा हुआ है, सोशल मीडिया में कोई पोस्टिंग लगाया, इसीलिए तेलंगाना के कांग्रेस अध्यक्ष को, तेलंगाना मुख्यमंत्री को हम अरेस्ट करते बोल के नोटिस लेकर तेलंगाना गांधी भवन में पहुंच गए। इसका मतलब नरेंद्र मोदी जी ईडी, इनकम टैक्स, सीबीआई हो गए, अभी दिल्ली पुलिस को इस्तेमाल कर रहे चुनाव जीतने के लिए। यहाँ पर कोई धरने वाले नहीं है भाई, यहाँ पर पलट के जवाब देने वाले है। देखेंगे आने वाले चुनाव में नरेंद्र मोदी जी और अमित शाह को हरा के दिखाएंगे कर्नाटक और तेलंगाना में।
Okay, so that's the reaction that's come in from the Telangana Chief Minister Revant Reddy. I want to bring in Arvind Oja on this broadcast to talk about the Delhi Police's investigation. Ab tak Arvind, ek team Telangana mein pahunch chuka hai, Hyderabad mein hai. Ek Assam Congress worker ko bhi arrest kiya hai ab tak. Kya kya hua hai Delhi Police investigation mein?
नहीं देखिए, दिल्ली पुलिस ने सबसे पहले एफआईआर रजिस्टर किया डिफरेंट सेक्शंस में। उसके बाद जिन लोगों ने जो ये डॉक्टर वीडियो, फेक वीडियो शेयर किया था, उनको आइडेंटिफाई किया, और सबसे पहले एक टीम तेलंगाना में पहुंची है। जो तेलंगाना के सीएम हैं, उनके समेत पांच कांग्रेस के जो लीडर हैं, उनको सम्मन दिया गया है, और 1 मई को पूछताछ के लिए दिल्ली बुलाया गया है। साथ ही साथ इन सबको कहा गया कि जो इनके इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइस है वो साथ में लेकर आए। अगर असम की बात करें तो वहां पर असम पुलिस ने एक एफआईआर रजिस्टर्ड किया था उस मामले में, और उससे पूछताछ वहां पर की जा रही है। काफी वाइडली ये जो डॉक्टर्ड वीडियो है होम मिनिस्टर का, वो शेयर किया गया था। दिल्ली पुलिस ने सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म एक्स और फेसबुक से भी जानकारी मांगी है कि ये वीडियो कहां से ओरिजिनेट हुआ, किसने ये वीडियो बनाया, किसने सबसे पहले इसको शेयर किया। तो दिल्ली पुलिस इस पूरे इन्वेस्टिगेशन को काफी सीरियस ले रही है, और इसी वजह से एक टीम तेलंगाना में पहुंची हुई है, जहां पर तेलंगाना के सीएम और पांच जो कांग्रेस के लीडर हैं, उनको सम्मन भेजा गया है पूछताछ के लिए 1 मई को दिल्ली। बताया गया है अक्षिता।
ओके, सो द नोटिस इश्यूड फॉर 1 मई सीकिंग अ रिस्पॉन्स फ्रॉम मिस्टर रेवंत रेड्डी एंड ऑल द अदर्स हु हैव शेयर्ड दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो। थैंक्स वेरी मच अरविंद, थैंक्स टू अब्दुल बशीर ऑल्सो फॉर गेटिंग अस ऑल ऑफ दोज अपडेट्स। दिस पर्टिकुलर इश्यू ऑफ अ डॉक्टर्ड वीडियो ऑफ होम मिनिस्टर अमित शाह बीइंग शेयर्ड एस्केलेटिंग नाउ इनटू अ पॉलिटिकल फेस ऑफ विद अ नोटिस बीइंग इश्यूड टू तेलंगाना चीफ मिनिस्टर रेवंत रेड्डी। लेट्स कट अक्रॉस टू मोर ब्रेकिंग न्यूज कमिंग इन। Now remember that even as we're seeing this war of words over Amit Shah's doctored video, which is on reservation on caste quota, the face-off between the BJP and the Congress is escalating directly between Rahul Gandhi and Prime Minister Modi. Rahul Gandhi in every single rally today has been saying one thing, that the BJP will come to power and end reservation, end caste quota. Rahul Gandhi's alleged that the Prime Minister's mission, Prime Minister Modi's mission, is to finish the constitution. And Rahul Gandhi is saying that the Prime Minister and the BJP have said that they will end reservation as it exists. Prime Minister Modi, in his rallies, has been making it a point to lash out at the Congress on this, accusing them of misleading people on the issue of reservation. Let's play out for you what Rahul Gandhi has said and what Prime Minister Modi has said.
आरक्षण का मतलब क्या है सबसे पहले कि देश में गरीबों की, दलितों की, आदिवासियों की, पिछड़ों की भागीदारी होगी। यह है मतलब कि देश में जो सत्ता है, जो धन है, उसे न्याय के साथ बिना अन्याय बांटा जाएगा। रिजर्वेशन का यह मतलब है। रिजर्वेशन को खत्म करने का तरीका प्राइवेटाइजेशन, रिजर्वेशन को खत्म करने का तरीका अग्निवीर। जहां भी कमजोर लोगों को थोड़ा सा फायदा मिलता है, किसानों को थोड़ा सा फायदा मिलता है, मजदूरों को, छोटे व्यापारियों को थोड़ा सा फायदा मिलता है, वहां ये लोग, उनका ध्यान चला जाता है और उसको बंद करने की कोशिश करते हैं।
मैं जरा जो लोग आरक्षण के नाम पर झूठ बोल बोल करके हमारे देश के लोगों को गुमराह करने में लगे हैं, मैं जरा चुभने वाला एक सवाल उनको पूछना चाहता हूं। इतने आरक्षण के गीत गा रहे हो, क्या जम्मू कश्मीर में रहने वाले आदिवासी, जम्मू कश्मीर रहने वाले दलित, क्या वो आरक्षण के हकदार थे कि नहीं थे? जब देश के दलितों को आरक्षण मिल सकता है, देश के आदिवासियों को आरक्षण मिल सकता है, तो जम्मू कश्मीर में मेरे दलित भाई बहनों को, मेरे आदिवासी भाई बहनों को आरक्षण से वंचित क्यों रखा गया? संविधान वहां पर लागू क्यों नहीं किया? क्योंकि वोट बैंक की राजनीति आप पर हावी रही है।
Now, as this war of words continues, what we're also witnessing in this election campaign is the use, or rather the misuse, of technology, particularly on social media, where there's also a very real threat, not just of doctored videos like the one you saw with Home Minister Amit Shah, but also of deep fakes. Celebrities particularly are falling prey to deep fake videos. Recently, you had two actors, superstar Aamir Khan as well as Ranveer Singh, flagging off their fake videos where they're seemingly endorsing a political party.
Modi ji ka purpose yahi hai. Unka uddeshya yahi tha ki wo celebrate kare hamari dukhi hui jeevan aur dar ko.
His expressions twisted, his likeness and words fabricated.
आज ऐसा अनुभव हुआ कि मैं शब्दों में बयान नहीं कर पा रहा हूँ।
Ranveer Singh's authentic moments in the sacred city of Varanasi, alongside actor Kriti Sanon, marred by digital manipulation. Star's voice contorted into political propaganda during the crucial Lok Sabha elections. Ranveer Singh's deep fake video went viral, a mischievous attempt to sway public opinion.
को मांगना कभी नहीं भूलना चाहिए, इसलिए सोचो और वोट दो।
जिन्हें देश की फिक्र है वो न्याय के लिए वोट देगा।
Ranveer Singh swiftly issued a warning to his followers, cautioning them against the deceptive nature of such videos. Ranbir has filed a complaint with the Mumbai police over his deepfake video. His team says investigation is on in the case. Ranveer Singh isn't the only victim in Bollywood. Aamir Khan recently faced a similar ordeal with a fake endorsement surfacing during the elections.
दोस्तों, इस चुनाव में दो तरह की गारंटीज है, एक अच्छी और एक बुरी.
The 59-year-old superstar has also lodged a complaint with the cyber crime cell of the Mumbai police.
नई टेक्नोलॉजी के साथ हमें बहुत सतर्क रहना होता है.
Earlier, the Prime Minister himself alerted the nation about the scourge of deepfakes.
नई टेक्नोलॉजी के साथ हमें बहुत सतर्क रहना होता है. अगर इनका नियमों से इस्तेमाल हो तो ये बहुत उपयोगी है, लेकिन अगर गलत तरीके से प्रयोग किया जाए तो इससे बड़ी समस्याएं हो सकती है. आप सब जनरेटिव एआई से बन रहे डीप फेक वीडियोस के बारे में जानते हैं, जो एकदम देखने वाले को एकदम असली दिखते हैं. इसलिए हमें किसी भी वीडियो या फोटो पर विश्वास करने से पहले अधिक सतर्क होने की जरूरत है.
The latest incidents present a stark reminder of the rampant spread of AI-generated falsehoods in these elections. Bureau Report, India Today.
Union Minister Smriti Irani has filed her nomination from Amethi today as a BJP candidate amid a massive show of strength. She was accompanied by top BJP leaders, and this at a time when we still don't know who's going to be taking on Smriti. The Congress is yet to announce who their Amethi candidate is. And there's endless speculation that there could just be an announcement that it is, after all, Rahul Gandhi.
Battle for Amethi heats up. Union Minister Smriti Irani filed her nomination from the Lok Sabha constituency on Monday.
सेवा के नए संकल्प के साथ आज मुख्यमंत्री मोहन यादव जी के सानिध्य में यशस्वी प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी से प्रेरित भारतीय जनता पार्टी की प्रत्याशी के नाते अमेठी की सेवा में आज मैंने अपना नामांकन अमेठी की जनता के आशीर्वाद समर्थकों के सहयोग से भरा.
Accompanied by Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Mohan Yadav and other BJP leaders, Smriti Irani held a roadshow from the BJP office in Gauriganj before filing her papers. Smriti Irani had won the Gandhi family bastion of Amethi by defeating Congress leader Rahul Gandhi in 2019. The Congress has not yet announced its candidate for the seat. The UP leadership of Congress wants Rahul to contest from Amethi and Priyanka Gandhi Vadra from Rai Bareli, which was represented by Sonia Gandhi.
घोषणा जल्दी हो जाएगी. अभी जो कल लास्ट मीटिंग हुई थी उसमें ये चर्चा का एक बिंदु था, लेकिन इस पर विस्तार से चर्चा नहीं हो पाई. हमको बताया गया कि खारगे जी अध्यक्ष जी इस पर निर्णय लेकर जल्द घोषणा करेंगे. मैं उम्मीद करता हूं कि एक दो दिन में घोषणा हो जाएगी. 3 तारीख से पहले पर्चे भरने जाएंगे.
Amethi is scheduled to go to polls in the fifth phase of the Lok Sabha elections on May 20th.
With a massive show and support of the workers and the people in general on the roads, Smriti filed her nomination, claiming a victory once again with a bigger margin. But the politics in Amethi is still getting narrowed down to only one question: who is going to challenge Smriti as a barrier for a victory in Amethi for the second time. With cameraman Gaurav Abhishek Mishra for India Today.
And let's bring in our reporters on this broadcast. We've got Abhishek Mishra joining us live from Amethi, where all the political action is, and Moshmi Singh joining us live from Delhi. Abhishek, to you first, what's the mood in Amethi? You know, there's endless speculation across the country over who will take on Smriti Irani. Smriti constantly says that whoever it is that the Congress feels, it doesn't matter, she will win. In your conversations with the people of Amethi, does it really matter who the Congress candidate is, or is it easy sailing for Smriti?
Well, to be honest, it is going to be a very, tough fight indeed, because we have seen on the ground how there is still a sentiment for the Gandhi family. Although today in the nomination, we have witnessed, more than 2,000 to 3,000 people participated, and it gone beyond to that point. But, it usually happens that in a road show, there is a lot of participation, there is a lot of, a pomp and show happening. But will it actually translate into votes? That is something makes a significance. Now, what we are getting to know is that, there is a possibility that Rahul's candidature announcement could be made possibly just 1 or 2 days before the final date of nomination. Now, what the congressmen believe here that there is no need to make that, public as of now. They feel that, the ground has already been prepared. There is a sentiment, the voices are there. And that is why they feel that even if that announcement is late or at the last moment, still Rahul Gandhi or anyone from the family, specifically Gandhi family, will be a tough contender. So that is what is happening. Yeah. But yes, there are some people who believe that Smriti would be able to retain it. She has prepared her ground. It's going to be a tough battle. But again, remains to be seen only and only if Congress feels Rahul Gandhi from that seat to challenge Smriti for the second consecutive time. Yes.
So let's take that point forward with Moshmi on this. Moshmi, May 3rd is the last date for filing nomination. That's just about 3 days away. Now, the Congress will be feeling considerable pressure to go ahead and name their candidate. There has to be some sort of a campaign on ground.
Right, Akshita. So, as Abhishek pointed out, the groundwork as far as, booth-level management, block-level management is already being done. There is a machinery in place, specifically in Raebareli and Amethi, if not the entire UP, as far as the Congress is concerned. Though I must say that it's turning out to be one of the most talked about political mysteries about who's going to contest in Raebareli and Amethi. And the Congress feels somewhere, Akshita, that they've been able to control that narrative as far as the contest in Amethi is concerned. You've seen that there have been no hold barred attack by Smriti Irani, constantly getting the Gandhis and the brother-in-law Robert Wadra in the picture. So, and a lot of hype and suspense has been built up. So it's perhaps wearing down the enemy before you launch yourself in the battlefield.
Sure. Interesting take, Moshmi and Abhishek. Thanks very much for joining us with all of those details. I'd like to also bring in on this broadcast Rajdeep Sardesaya, consulting editor. Rajdeep, good evening. What are your sources telling you, Rajdeep? Will Rahul and Priyanka contest from Amethi and Raebareli respectively?
Well, thanks very much, Akshita. Yes, what I'm hearing at the moment is that the Congress election committee headed by the party president, Mallikarjun Kharge, is very keen that Rahul Gandhi contests from Amethi. And we are told that Mr. Kharge has had a conversation with Mr. Gandhi in the last few days. And the ball is now really in Rahul Gandhi's court. The fact is that the general expectation, certainly in the Amethi unit of the Congress, is that Rahul Gandhi will contest. That's the buzz that we are picking up. The Congress leadership of Mallikarjun Kharge is keen that Rahul Gandhi contest. But what is in Rahul Gandhi's mind, only Rahul Gandhi and his very close associates really know. And that's where the problem lies, because you speak to Congress person and they say, well, we are hopeful that Rahul Gandhi will contest from Amethi or Raebareli. Let me now add that. Amethi or Raebareli. Interestingly, there are those who believe that Raebareli is possibly a safer constituency for Rahul Gandhi. That's the constituency. Sure. Sonia Gandhi has been winning multiple times, that Indira Gandhi won several times. So there's one view that if not Amethi, then Rahul Gandhi should contest Rae Bareli, but almost certainly one of the two is the view being expressed. And we should know, hopefully, in the next 48 hours, whether Rahul Gandhi is actually taking that plunge, okay, beat in Amethi and taking on Smriti Irani or Rae Bareli, which some Congress people believe is a safer seat for Rahul Gandhi at the moment.
Okay, but Rajdeep, also, you know, this is incredibly last minute, whether it's Amethi or Rae Bareli. Let's take the example of Amethi. The BJP's Smriti Irani has already filed a nomination today. The Congress hasn't even named their candidate. If it is Rahul Gandhi, is this dicey because there's no time for him to campaign whatsoever?
Look, there are still a couple of days left for the nominations to end. And the speculation continues, therefore, over both Rahul and Priyanka Gandhi Vadra. We've been saying this for a while, that it's very unlikely that Priyanka Gandhi Vadra will contest because she's decided to focus on campaigning across the country. And she's proving to be the most effective campaigner in many ways for the Congress at the moment. Someone who's taking the battle in a way to the BJP camp. So Priyanka Gandhi Vadra, unlikely that she will contest. The more the speculation continues over Rahul Gandhi, clearly the Congress is playing the waiting game. It doesn't help, you're right, because everyone wants certainty. The party on the ground in Uttar Pradesh is facing a very uphill struggle, and indeed across North India. You might have seen today a Congress candidate has withdrawn at the last moment from Indore. So yes, the last thing the Congress wants is to send out a message across North and Central India that even their leadership has a defeatist mindset. So you would expect Mr. Gandhi to contest, but look, Rahul Gandhi is capable of pulling up all kinds of surprises, and I think it's best to wait for the next 48 hours and then we'll know whether this last minute decision either way has worked to the Congress's advantage or not. My own sense is the longer the party delays a decision, the mm-hmm. more it really doesn't work in favor of the party on the ground in the key state of Uttar Pradesh.
Very true. May 3rd is the last day to file nominations. So in the next 48 hours, for sure, there will be an answer on who exactly is fighting from Amethi and Rae Bareli and whether Rahul and Priyanka are actually going to be fighting from UP. Thanks very much, Rajdeep, for joining us as always with your insights on what is expected really in that big UP battle, the two seats that everyone's talking about. Let's also tell you about the other big nomination that was filed today in Uttar Pradesh, and that was Rajnath Singh, who went ahead and filed his nomination from his bastion of Lucknow. It was essentially a saffron show of strength when you look at what happened in Amethi with Smriti Irani, and then on the other hand, Rajnath Singh, who filed his nomination papers as well. There was a massive roadshow before he filed his papers. He was accompanied by UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath, as well as Uttarakhand Chief Minister पुष्कर सिंह धामी.
आप दो दफा यहां पर पहले भी चुनाव जीत चुके हैं, 14 में और 19 में. जब आप तुलना करते हैं पहले के दो चुनाव में, इस बार लखनऊ की लड़ाई को पहले की तुलना में, आप क्या फर्क पाते हैं, क्या आपको लगता है कि से?
वैसे मैं समझता हूं कि कल से ही आप लखनऊ में हैं और चूंकि पत्रकारिता जगत से जुड़े हुए हैं आप, तो निश्चित रूप से आपने लोगों से संपर्क किया होगा और यहां की राजनीतिक स्थिति का जायजा लिया होगा आपने. मुझे विश्वास है कि पहले भी यहाँ की जनता का विश्वास मुझे प्राप्त था और इस बार भी पहले से कहीं अच्छा परफॉर्मेंस इस बार के चुनाव परिणाम का रहेगा, ऐसा मेरा विश्वास है.
सर, पहले दो चरण का जो मतदान रहा उसका एक फीचर निकल के आ रहा है कि इस बार लोगों में उस तरह का जोश और जुनून नहीं है वोटिंग को लेकर जो कि 2014 और 19 में था. पिछले चुनाव से करीब 4% दोनों फेजेस मिला के वोटिंग परसेंटेज डाउन है. इसको आप कैसे देखते हैं, क्योंकि आप चुनाव के बहुत अच्छे विश्लेषक भी हैं, वोटिंग परसेंटेज जो घट रही है उसको आप कैसे देखते हैं?
देखिए, वोटिंग परसेंटेज घटने का एक कारण तो गर्मी भी है, लेकिन उसके साथ साथ जो आपने कहा कि लोगों के अंदर उत्साह नहीं है, तो लोग यह मानकर चल रहे हैं कि चाहे जो कुछ भी हो, पहले से कहीं अधिक अच्छी मेजोरिटी से.
And we're cutting across now to an exclusive conversation with Home Minister Amit Shah amid that controversy over his doctored video going viral.
अमित शाह इस समय गुवाहाटी में एक रोड शो कर रहे हैं और भारतीय जनता पार्टी के समर्थन के लिए लाखों लोग सड़कों पर उतर आए हैं. अमित जी, जिस तरीके की भीड़ यहाँ नजर आ रही है, बहुत सारी महिलाएं हैं, आपको लगता है महिलाएं सिर्फ बंगाल में ही नहीं, नॉर्थ ईस्ट में भी आप लोगों को सपोर्ट कर रही हैं, भाजपा को सपोर्ट कर रही हैं?
जी निश्चित रूप से, पूरे उत्तर पूर्व में, नॉर्थ ईस्ट में मोदी जी का प्रचंड जन समर्थन है। 1.5 किलोमीटर के रोड शो में 7 किलोमीटर दूर से भीड़ है। रोड शो का पॉइंट तो अभी आया भी नहीं और ये हजारों हजारों लाखों लोग रोड पर उमटे हुए, ये बताता है कि मोदी जी का प्रचंड जन समर्थन है। निश्चित रूप से हम 400 पार के बहुमत के साथ तीसरी बार सरकार है।
हमें जी एक तरफ यहाँ पे जन सैलाब नजर आता है, दूसरी तरफ है राहुल गांधी जो ये बयान देते हैं कि 150 पे अटक जाएगी भाजपा, जिनको ऐसा लगता है कि अब की बार भाजपा नहीं समझ रही है।
देखिए, आपके अलावा देश में इनको कोई सीरियसली नहीं लेता, आप भी मत लीजिए।
क्या आपको ऐसा लगता है अमित जी कि महिलाओं का अब की बार आप लोगों का बहुत समर्थन रहेगा? हमने देखा किस तरीके से संदेश खाली का केस सामने आया, ममता बनर्जी से आपने सवाल पूछे, उन्होंने जवाब नहीं दिए। बंगाल को लेकर
संदेश खाली राजनीति का मुद्दा नहीं है, कोई सरकार जिसकी मुखिया महिला हो वो सरकार वोट बैंक की पॉलिटिक्स के लिए, तुष्टिकरण के लिए महिलाओं का शोषण सालों तक अपने पार्टी के नेताओं से होने दे, इससे ज्यादा शर्मनाक बात और कोई नहीं है।
क्या आपको लगता है अब की बार 400 पार एक हकीकत बनेगा? 400 पार एक हकीकत होगी?
निश्चित रूप से हम 400 पार।
एक आखिरी सवाल अमित जी, कई सारे वीडियोस आते हैं जो डीप फेक बन जाते हैं, क्या आपको लगता है कि लोगों को सतर्क रहना चाहिए डीप फेक वीडियोस को लेके?
देखिए, हमारी ओर से एक भी नहीं आया है, तीन आए, तीनों तीन कांग्रेस ने करे, यही बताता है कांग्रेस जन समर्थन के अभाव में इस प्रकार के गलत प्रचार के लिए पड़ी, वो उनकी हार की हताशा की निशानी है।
तो यहाँ गृह मंत्री अमित शाह का कहना है कि डीप फेक वीडियो जो है वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी की तरफ से नहीं, ऑपोजिशन पार्टीज की तरफ से जारी किए जा रहे हैं और हर किसी को ये देखना चाहिए कि डीप फेक वीडियो से उनका नुकसान कितना हो रहा है और 400 पार अब की बार सिर्फ एक नारा नहीं एक हकीकत बनेगा। कैमरा पर्सन नितेश के साथ ऐश्वर्या पालीवाल, आज तक।
Let's get you an excerpt of the exclusive conversation that India Today's Rajdeep Sardesai had with Andhra Chief Minister Jagan Mohan Reddy. So much at stake in Andhra Pradesh, because remember that it's not just a general election but also an assembly election in the state of Andhra. And as we've been seeing political battle lines being drawn, here is the conversation that Rajdeep had with Jagan on the alliance, the possible post-poll alliance with the BJP. And also about the attack that happened on him during his bus yatra.
What is the nature of relationship? For the last 5 years, we've seen in parliament, outside parliament, by and large, YSRCP has supported Prime Minister Modi. Now we are told because you've got a strong minority vote here, you don't want to be seen to be on the same side as the Prime Minister. What is the reality of your relationship with the centre and the Prime Minister?
I think rather than asking me, Rajdeep, they are the people who tied up, they are the people who are currently in tie up with Chandrababu Naidu. So you should ask Chandrababu Naidu and Modi what their relationship is.
He says we are, Mr. Naidu says we are together for development. Both Prime Minister and I want the development of Andhra Pradesh.
So if they are together, it is development. If Jagan and I were to maintain a cordial relationship because I am the Chief Minister and because he is the Prime Minister, then it's for something else.
Would you support the government at the center if, let's say, Mr. Modi is 20 seats short, you have 20 MPs?
See, why do we talk about a hypothetical situation when they're together fighting against me and I'm fighting against them? So where is the question of this hypothetical situation coming up?
This election, your sister, as I said, has been pitted against you. Does that trouble you? Does that leave you dismayed that your legacy is getting fractured and the Congress party, of which he was the chief minister, has put up the sister? Why is Sharmila?
No, what I'm hurt is not because she's contesting. The reason I'm hurt is because she will lose deposits. It pains me the most to see her lose deposits, because what she's done is not right. The very party that has put my father's name in the charge sheet, the very party that has filed these fabricated cases on me. And you know who the petitioners in my case are? None other than Congress and TDP. And today, you know who's driving my sister or the Congress party in the state? None other than Chandrababu Naidu through Revanth.
You're making a very serious allegation. You're claiming Chandrababu Naidu and Revant Reddy have propped up Y. Sharmila to take you on in Andhra Pradesh.
Absolutely. Congress party is remote controlled by Chandrababu Naidu, as the BJP is being remote controlled by Chandrababu Naidu. Today, Jagan is fighting just not one BJP. He's also fighting the Congress.
And Chandrababu Naidu, it seems to have become very personal. Even during this campaign, it's become very personal, the kind of language you use against each other. And Mr. Naidu claims that this entire incident of you being hit by a stone is drama. For Jagan is trying to create sympathy for himself. Nothing like this happened. Some small stone was thrown. These are his words. And Jagan Mohan Reddy has created this drama to get sympathy. So it's gone down to that level. He claimed that you arrested him wrongfully, sent him to prison. That Jagan Mohan Reddy is running Andhra like a dictator. Anyone who questions him is thrown into prison.
I think the most important thing is, Rajdeep, see the stone what they speak about. Who threw the stone? It was their people who got this, who actually threw the stone.
He denies that.
What are we talking here, Rajdeep? And somebody has the audacity to actually say that. I mean, if Chandrababu Naidu feels so like that, let Chandrababu Naidu stand there. I'll give you the opportunity to throw 10 stones at him at the same speed at which I was hit, each resulting in 3 stitches. And let sympathy come to him.
And you can catch that full 30-minute interview with Andhra Chief Minister Jagan Mohan Reddy at 10:30 this evening on a special edition of Elections Unlocked with Rajdeep Sardesai.